Incorporating a refreshed date timestamp into your Power BI report increases the credibility of your report, and it allows users to confirm whether the report is up to date or not. When deciding to include a refreshed date timestamp, you need to consider whether you want to have a refreshed date timestamp for your entire report or just for the specific data file. If your Power BI report updates daily, but the data file source is only updated monthly, you should use the refreshed date for the data file. On the other hand, if all sources are updated with fairly the same frequency as the Power BI report, you should add a refresh date timestamp for the entire report. Having both might confuse the end user, so understand your needs before choosing which one to use. So, let's add a report refresh date to our report. We press transform. Next, we add a blank query. We start by adding hashtag table and parentheses. We add brackets. The first one contains the column name, while the next one contains the values. To get today, we add DateTime.LocalNow with a closed parentheses at the end. And lastly, we format the value as a date. When we update the report, this value will automatically update to the point of time where the report has been updated. Now, let's add a date file refresh date to our report. In this case, we use the file called Superstore as our source data. As this file doesn't contain any timestamps, we need a workaround to fetch the last time of update. Here we choose New Source, More, and Connect to a folder. We select the right folder and press Transform Data. We see all the files in the folder and filter down to the specific source we need. As this table contains timestamps, we just remove other columns to isolate the timestamp of the report. We rename the table to something meaningful and press Close and Apply. We can now incorporate visual cards to display the refresh dates. By default, Power BI loads the earliest value. However, since the table always only contains one value, it doesn't matter whether Power BI applies the minimum or maximum value here. That's pretty much it. I hope you've enjoyed it. Please like and subscribe, and bye for now.